Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Barbell, and welcome back to some more Fallout 4 Settlement Series action. In today's episode, we're actually going to get some things built. I spent some time off camera since the first episode, and I believe I'm a lot more comfortable with the building system now. I'm pretty excited to get this started. I apologize that I didn't really do much in the first video. Oh my god, we need to take this out. This is so bad. And by the way, this video and the previous one takes place between part 6 and 7 of the main Fallout 4 Let's Play, just to keep you informed of where we are. One of the things I'm going to do is I'm going to take this shack down, take everything inside out. I also took out those stupid wooden planks I put on the floor over here. I put like 3 and I'm like, done! It is perfect! There's nothing more I can do. So, as you can see, I took those away. We're going to make a custom house here too, I think. I'm probably going to put the prefab metal, the giant metal building here for my workshop area. I don't know if I mentioned it, but when I take this out, I'm going to make probably a custom-built house for the settlers as well. I am going to give the places power as well, so we're going to have lights. People will not just be standing around in the dark, kind of like running into each other. So I guess, also, like, as I loaded up the game, I walked near Preston and he gave me a new quest. Which, by the way, he appears to be stuck here. I don't know what he's doing, so let me...
Another settlement has sent word that they need our help. We've got to show people the Minuteman can really help.
Wait, what? He just gave me another one! That's not the one I was talking about! Kidnapping at Greentop Nursery? There's another one that involved ghouls. Ghoul problem at County Crossing. Oh, great. I love me some ghouls. Goosebumps.
Hi. Is there something you need?
I need you to get out of there.
I need your help.
Sure. Come with me if you want to live.
I think the folks here can manage on their own now. Thanks to you.
Okay. Become unstuck. Hooray! Because normally he patrols the streets, but he's just been standing over there by that workbench for the longest time. Roughly 5.5 years. Nearly 6. Really? He's like, yoink, taking that chair from Grandma Sear in the slippers.
You're tied to this place, kid.
Your energy.
No, no. Look away. It won't let me look away. Okay, Preston.
Hey.
Hey.
What do you need?
I need you to stay here.
Hey. Need something?
Hey. Dismiss.
It's time for you to head home.
Mid-drank. Sanctuary Hills. Travel there.
You know where to find me if you need me.
Indeed. Okay. I just wanted to get him off that workbench. Also, Piper is still here. Even though that's not Piper, I'm going to pretend that I did not think that was Piper walking by. Okay, I totally thought that was Piper walking by. Also, I have a couple things to show you guys before we do that building. And I'm excited about this, because I found these things on my own. Which, by the way, I'm not looking up guides or anything. I want to learn everything in the game, or as much as I can, on my own. Because I only get one time to play this, you know, for the first time. So I don't want to ruin it by just looking everything up myself. There was a chemistry station here, by the way. I found it. It was out back behind this building. Let me kind of go out front so you can get a better understanding of where I'm at. Here you go. There's the bridge. And it's the first non-scrappable house on the left. It's the yellow one. Anyway, there's a chem station back there. And what I did is I picked it up and I moved it all the way over here to like this central building. There it is. If you guys remember in the first episode of this, I showed you how to move things. Anyway, look at this. Have you seen this? Have you read about this? This is pretty neat. Also, I hear Piper talking about a printing press. Get out, please. Thanks. There she is, just walking around, yucking it up. Now watch this. I'm particularly proud of this discovery I made. Now, if you can see where I'm at here, there's the cul-de-sac down there. It's the last blue house on the left. Just swiggity-swooty your way around back for that house's booty, and look at this! Root cellar! There's a cellar back here. You can actually go inside. Lo and behold, there are goodies down here! I didn't loot any of this because as soon as I found it, I was like, yes, I have to show this off in the episode, so I didn't touch nothing. Pork and beans. I wonder if any of these have, like, rads because they're underground. Maybe they were okay. Until then, I'm just gonna leave it. Gold bars! There's gold bars down here! I don't know what the purpose of these are. Purified water. purified water. Duct tape flip lighter. Can. Still a graveyard smash with that insta mash. Ooh, 45 rounds. Blamco brand mac and cheese, no thanks.
Lock's really strong.
It's really strong. Aluminum can, purified water, tin can. Aluminum can. Can. Pre-war money. Cha-ching! And I think that's pretty much everything down here. Nothing super special, but it's a neat little discovery that I made. And I'm happy about it, okay? Let me have a little happiness. So that's pretty neat. I don't know if any of you knew about this or not. Probably. You probably did. But I didn't see any comments about it, so I was like, hey. Maybe I done good. I don't really see anything else, although knowing my luck, there's a bobblehead or a magazine down here. Burnt. Ugh, I thought that was something. I guess not, because it's all burnt. Maybe there's something cool in the chest. But I don't have the advanced lockpicking yet. Okay, let's peace on out and start some building. So first thing we're going to take care of is the settler's house, and then we're going to build mine, and then we're just going to plop down the workshop prefab. And I think we're also going to do a Minuteman quest. Either the one I just got or the ghouls one. And I'm also debating on what I want to do with my weapons. Because as you guys well know, based on my perks, I am not built for a... Whoops-a-daisy! I didn't know someone was up there sleeping! My bad! I'm taking everyone's beds! You're all... What happened here? What's this? Oh, that was the bed that was upstairs and just got kind of teleported down below. So there's a person talking two beds at once and this one gets nothing. Go here. Everyone, go. Go away. You. Wake up! I'm tearing your house down at like 4 in the morning. I do what I want. Okay, can I scrap this now? Scrap. Actually, maybe I should just move it. I've already built- No! Ah! No. Oh, damn it. I want to move it slightly. Thank you. Okay. So I guess you could assign a bed to- or assign someone to a bed. That's cool. Make them use the same bed every time. Oh, damn it. Oh, here we go. No! Fuck! Stop it! Okay. Can you please walk away? Are they all gonna go sleep in the middle of the street? I mean, you gotta do what you gotta do, and it is a relatively nice night. Okay. So we're gonna go with wood. And let me see if I can remember how I did this. Because I actually, what I did is, off camera, I did a lot of test building. And then I'd reload a save. So everything I did didn't just give me free experience. I reloaded a save and then I try again and repeat and repeat and repeat. Cha-ching! Level up! That might be a little too far forward. Now, as of recording this, I have not yet released part one of the series, so... In that video, I asked you guys how much did you want to see? Did you want me to cut a bunch of stuff out until I accomplish something? I still don't know the answer to that, so until then, you're gonna see all the building and its building glory. Also, that's... kind of wonky. I don't... Wait a second here. Well, no, wait a minute. Wait. That's the one I wanted. I don't want this. Scrap. Prefabs. Yeah, this one. Floor and roof. If you guys see, if you look at the roof there. It's kind of wonky. A little wonky. There, now it's nice and flat. Now I can just move it where I want it. Okay. No. That's one thing I don't like, is if... See, if I'm looking around down here in this menu, but I happen to have something highlighted above me, like the floor and roof is right now, and then I press E to pick structures, wood, floors, it'll pick up the highlighted thing. It's like, damn it, you gotta go out here and make sure nothing's highlighted before you start messing around in the menu. So if I do prefabs and then... Let's do more of this same thing here. I want to create like an open center area if I can. The problem is these... You see these foundations here? They're kind of small. And technically you can just like build off of them and just have things floating off the ground, but that's weird. It's weird, okay? Shit. You see what I mean? Do you see? Like these foundations need to be twice the size they are. That would have been perfect, in my opinion. So, what I want to do here is hallway. Where's end hallway? Here we go. Cha-ching! Whoops, whoops. I didn't want to do that. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, well, I just figured out an answer to the problem I just complained about 60 seconds ago. I think. If I'm highlighting... Yeah, if I have something highlighted and I'm looking in the menu, I want to select it. Pressing the up arrow key over the highlighted thing in the menu allows me to select that without accidentally moving something above me. Well, that's good. Okay. Now, what I'm trying to do here, which I don't think I'll be able to do... Yeah, see, what I want to do is just make like a giant open area. Scrap that for a second. You know, I might just build off the foundation. Say, screw it. It can't be perfect. Because what I want is a big open area and then have like little individual areas for people's rooms. Now what's this look like? Now, can I put that there and then put a wall outside right here? Because I don't want this just to be open. Walls. Big cow in the house with outer cap. What the hell is outer cap? What the hell does that mean? Is that like that little overhang there? You see, if I put it that way, you see that? Shack wall with corner. This looks like an outhouse if I turn it this way. Shack wall and roof. Straight up wall. A lot of walls in the wall menu. Who'd have thunk that? Wow. Wall small. Ooh, that's kind of neat. I think I want to make sure it all kind of matches, though. What's that wall look like? This one just has a whole bunch of jibba jabba just kind of glued together. Let's try that one. That's okay. It's not perfect, but, man. See, I wish the planks were a lot tighter like this wall is here. See, there's a lot of open area for breezes and peeping toms. Oh well. We might just go with that for now. These can always be modified later if I want to. Okay, so let's go back to here. And I want this. And then hallway end, maybe. Or maybe not. Maybe I can just do this again. Okay. Alright, there. And then hallway end right here. Wait, which way is that? Where's the opening? There it is. Right there. Let's see how that looks. Yep, we got people sleeping in the middle of the street. I don't build any temporary residence for these people. I guess I could put them in the houses that are already built over there. Nope. Don't even care. Okay, so as you can see, we got little individual rooms here. Plus a nice wide open area. Here. And then I'll probably put individual rooms here. Right? Let's look at that. What was it? Hallway end. Right here. And then put... What was it? Wall and roof. There. Okay. And I guess technically... This acts like some steps. So maybe I could put more things down here? oh, just kind of snaps up there like that. And if I try to put it here, I don't know. Hang on. Floor with roof. Oh, yeah. Even though there's steps there, it would just be like kind of open to the elements right here. So forget that. I think I have all the structures, like outside structures built. Mostly, yeah. Let's put the walls up. Walls. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Where's my menu? There it is. Well, let's just keep it consistent with all these. Oh, come on. Come on. Why? Why is it not? Okay, there we go. Up! Up! Get it on there! Come on, man. I know. I saw. Up! Up! Oh, finally. It's a struggle, man. It's an absolute struggle. Okay. I got that, and now we need to do the one with the doorway. Here we go. Now let's look at doors. Doors. What do we want? We got red, green, white, more green, more red, blue, more red, more blue, and more white. What's the least shitty looking one? The red kind of masks the scratches. Let's do red. Alright, let's exit the build menu. Let's quick save. Let's go on in. What's up with this one? Oh, I built the wonky one here! Crap! I don't want the wonky! We want symmetry! Alright. Scrap. Wood, prefabs, non-wonky. Okay. Look at this! Now it is kinda like off balance here. Wait a minute. I should've rotated these. Can I still rotate? Put it down. I know I'm going a bit overboard here, but most of the planks were going the correct way, and then these four pieces right here weren't. Gotta make it look fresh. We don't want no old busting in here. We want new hotness. There. See, now all the... Oh! No, they don't. They mostly go the same way. Let me guess. These don't... Okay, I can accept that. I think. Turn the light on. I might be going a bit far here with trying to get it perfect. So, I'm just gonna leave it here. If it bothers me enough, I'll come back off camera and replace these two endings right here with something else so all the wood... So all the wood floors go the same direction. But for now, this is fine. And I'm quite happy with how this custom-built house turned out. Because that wooden shack, that pre-built wooden shack, was just all kinds of janky. Let's see what Carla the Trash Lady has. Huh? Huh? Carla's like, oh, I love trash!
Here to trade?
What do you mean, me again? You're coming to my town! You're in my city! So I should be saying to you, you again, barter.
I'll take a look, sure.
Yeah, yeah, keep your shirt on.
No! I will take my shirt off and throw it on the floor. Because I do what I want. Pipe wrench? Security baton. I want that. 33 coin? Fine with me. Submachine gun. What kind of bullets does that take? 45s. Ooh. Baseball cap. Military cap. Padded blue jacket. What did Piper need? I think she needed the chest piece. I think she has all four limbs, but not the chest piece. So I'm going to take a risk and buy that without checking. Typical barbell. Baby rattle. Oh, that's just junk. 45 rounds. How much does this cost? Oh, four pieces of coin per bullet? Wow! I was debating on getting some use out of the submachine gun, but forget that! Yeah, forget that. And what did the snub-nosed revolver take? What was it, like 40-something, maybe? I don't know. I don't think it's 38s, even though it has that revolver on the box. It's false advertising. 50 caliber, whoa! What if there's like a 50 cal sniper in here? That'd be pretty radical. Oh well. Shotgun shells. Okay, this is fine. Thanks. So, let's find Piper. Also, I'm thinking I might build a second floor. But maybe for now this is fine. I only have 6 people here anyway. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6! Yeah! Look at that! A room for everyone! Poor Preston, man. Feels bad about this. Even though I gave him the painting to spruce up his outside area, it's not enough. So I think what I'm going to do to remind myself I want to eventually add in a second area is I'm going to put stairs. What's it? Does it want the stairs to go this way? That's fine, I guess. Although this seems a little more reasonable. But it automatically clicks going like that. Well, alright, let's just put it here. Cha-ching. That's fine. That's all kinds of fine. And we'll leave it at that. I don't have enough people to fill an upstairs any area anyway, so that's cool. We got a functioning door. Let's go ahead and actually just put down the metal prefab for my workshop now. Because that's easy. It's the giant one. Look at this! Look at this! Takes up 6 miles! I can't even see where I'm going with this. Here we go. Let's just place it down and see how it lines up on the foundation. Slightly askew. Slightly. Whoa, yeah. Pretty askew here. Let's try and fix that. Trying to line it up with the steps here. Huh. This looks like it should be okay. Is this on? Man, you take a step out this back door, you're gonna be flat on your face! Yeah, that's not great. Can I at least... Yeah, I can jump into it. I just did that. Okay, doors. I guess this is like the only metal-looking door. Metal? Walls? Yeah. Well, I guess I could make a custom build workshop area too, but for now, let me just keep this prefab up. It should suffice. I don't even know if I... Nope, I don't want to do it. Store this in the workshop? What do I do? Fold it up neatly and then just shove it in there? I don't know how that works. Can I even build the workshop items? Crafting. Oh, local leader 2, so no. So then this... Damn it! So this really doesn't matter at the moment. I'll just leave that there to have it. Now this is supposed to be my plot of land. Okay, these fences appear to be the only things I didn't take out. I guess I could take this tree out that's like on the house. Oh, maybe not, won't let me. Wait a minute, does that mean I can walk up there? Is there hidden goodies? Come on, you can do it. Come on! Do I need to... Oh, I need to be spooky to do it. This is the spooky tree. Aha! Man, I'm actually finding things. I am so happy. Man, and it's actually kind of fun to just sit back and do this building. I hope you guys don't mind watching it, although... I did explain what the series was going to be about, so if you're here watching, it's probably what you want to see. Okay, let's go ahead and work on the house. Which is also going to be a custom-built wooden house. I don't need to put floors down because there's already floors here. Now if we do it like this, maybe I will use the wonky one for mine. Because look, it has that that kind of raise right there. Like, yes, this is the grand mansion. Not just anyone lives here. This is Justin the Wanderer who lives here. And maybe his fist will wander to your face if you step foot inside. You know what I'm saying? So I guess we can just do this. Although, The floors aren't matching. Oh, look at this entryway. It's so fancy. Okay, I'm not gonna worry about the floors. I gotta tell myself, don't even worry about it. They're fine. And because I'm the only one who's gonna be living here, I can make it all open and stuff. Like that. Like that. Yeah, that's fine. Whoa. Why is it not letting me put it there? Is it because of bushes? Really? Who's the genius that put the bushes there? If it would interfere with building? Come on, man. Ugh. I can at least put this here, but I doubt I can put a wall on the other side to seal that off. Let's look, at least. No. I don't think so. Oop! Maybe. Okay, let's get the wall that I like. This one, right? Was this the one? No, that's not it. There it is. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Fit! Just shove it in there! It's not gonna cooperate, is it? Wow, I can put walls on my walls for extra protection. For extra wall action. Although that means I could... never mind, forget it. There was that one wall. Oh, okay, that fits. So let me see if I look right here. Right here. Okay, so only a couple walls are wanting to fit on there. Like that. But look at, it's just a bunch of boards kind of just thrown up there all willy-nilly. It doesn't look great. In fact, I dare say it looks less than great. Wall end? I mean wall end. Well, this one looked okay, didn't it? It's like trying to snap on there, but it's not. Oh, it's trying to snap on the back. Well, I don't want that. Wait, let me look at something. Where was that wall end? I was looking on wall end. Can that snap on here? Huh. It can. Look at that little extra room. Little extra room here. Okay, why don't we just do that? Walls. What was the one that I just built, though? I forget what it was called. Is this it? Yeah. Just regular wall. And then wall end was this one? Yeah. Well, maybe not. That's the one I put on there. I want this one. I don't want that one. I want this one. Sound all spoiled. There we go. Come on. It was just on there. It was just on there. Does it only want to be put on that way? Okay, that's okay. Wait. I should probably put a wall in here, too. Like that. And keep the walls and go back to the one I liked right here. And then put the doorway one. Which is like one of the first ones, I think. Yep, there it is. There. Okay, Man. Look at that. See, I get the fancy parts. I get the things that stick out, and that means I'm rich. I'm serious. Oh, do I have a graveyard in my backyard? Come on, nobody told me about this part. Who? Who was this? Can I rob their graves? No. Close that. I don't care if this bit of the fence is down. Or this bit. Okay. I also want to figure out how to make a second floor from within the house, if that makes sense. Like, have the stairs inside. Let's see here. If I have stairs... Wait, let me put a floor down. Like so. And then stairs. Here we go, kinda right here. Whoop! Ooh, well, no, that's okay. Let me just move it inwards a little more. A little more. Like that. And can I put a floor underneath it? Underneath it. No, it's not gonna... It says I don't wanna. That sucks. Wait, oh! Crap! What if I just died right there for absolutely no reason? I just died. Okay, so it does snap like this. So if I pull it back here. Back a little more. Go like that. See, I want it to be right here. Okay. Oh, really? Look how perfect that is! But it won't let me! There's gonna be a gap. Look for the gap. Do you see the gap? What a gap, man! If I want to go upstairs, I have to make sure I have to jump over. Oh, that sucks. Well, let's scrap that then. Maybe a prefab. Oh, well. Prefab can go up here. Prefab floor and roof. If I move this. And then go up. Yeah, see, it only wants to attach this way. Which means there's also going to be a gap between the roof of the lower floor and the floor of the second floor. Huh. Well, it appears I'm having trouble with second floors of the houses. Which means we'll deal with that later. I'll probably look into that more off camera as well. But at least we're getting other things built. And they look halfway decent. What are you doing? This guy is... Look at how pathetic this guy is! We need to whip him into shape. We need to, like, Mulan this junk. Let's get down to business. To defeat the Huns, man. Walls. What did I want to put here? What's the only thing that would fit? Oh yeah, it's this thing, right? Maybe not. This one? There was something that fit over here. And rotating it like this, it won't let me. Well, let's see if we can do a hall. Maybe I can do the hallway one. Hang on. Scrap that. Which, by the way, I do know that when you scrap things you built, you only get like half of what you invested to build it. But that's okay. Hallway. That's what I want. Let's try it this way. That's okay, I guess. I mean, it forces me to have a wall in the house, though. Although, maybe I can make this my bedroom. That could work. Yeah, let's go with that. Walls. Although, shit. Yeah, there's bushes coming through the wall, man! I don't want that to be my bedroom! Ugh! That That's so lame. Ah, I got an idea. Maybe, here we go. Can I put this up? Yeah. Put that up. Although, well, no, that's bad. Bad idea. Let's just put a wall. Like this. That is the one I'm using over here, right? Yeah. Yeah, okay. This could be the dog's area right here. His little... I don't know, hangout area. If dogs have those. So if I put a doorway here... And put walls all along here. Like, hya. Now let's get some door action. Isn't this exciting? It's gotta be so exciting. We're gonna put green doors because green is my favorite color. Did you know that? And let's take a look inside. Oh. This might be a problem. Oops, I kinda forgot about that. Alright, let's fix this. Let's fix it. Just scrap that for the moment. So what did I put here? What is this? Shack floor? Is this Shack Foo? Why did I put floors down here instead of the prefab with the roof? That's what I want. Right here. And then let's put the one with the thing. Right here. Because we fancy. Now we can put the walls up. Gotta go fast. Although I guess I could put the little extension thingy out here. Which is the one that looked all nice and neat, crisp and clean. I don't think there was one. That's not too bad looking. Then we put the end walls up. Oh, get out! Just... You know what? You get to sit here in the middle of the yard by yourself. That's what you get. This is the one. And... Okay. I should have an entire roof over my head. Yes, I do. Okay. Now this is a house. Well, post-apocalyptic house. But a house nonetheless. And I'm super happy I was able to construct it myself instead of using one of the giant prefab things. We've got functioning doors. Okay, well, okay, the survival, or the settler's house looks like a box. Mine is a little better because it has those raises, but once I add the fourth floor, okay, we're getting into skyscraper territory there. Four levels high apartment building. Anyway, once we get the second floor going, it'll look a little more, or a little less box-like. But... I guess I could put the beds in. We're also going to install power. I think that's going to be the next order of business for these houses, is we're going to install power and lights and so forth. So that's going to be good. Okay, sorry, boot. That had to pause the recording. Mom's trying to kill us, but the Commonwealth never lacks for excitement. She is super nonchalant about being shot at constantly. All right.
Stays hidden forever. At least, not if I have my say.
Let's give you the armor. Stop!
Hey, Piper.
Head my way.
Trade.
Let's trade.
This is what I've got.
Okay. Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, take the pistol. Where the hell did you get all this shit? Oh, that's right. I just stuffed her pockets full of things that I had because I didn't have the room for it. We'll just take all of it. Okay. And we'll give her the chest piece, which I was right. She didn't have that. Equip. Oh. It's not so much a chest piece as it is a belt and sash, but alright. And she needs a better hat, I think. Let's take the press cap for a second, or just unequip it. I don't know. Maybe she likes her hat. Maybe I'll leave the hat until I find something cooler. Sack hood with straps! No, probably not. It's like a gimp outfit or something. Might give people the wrong idea. Just straight up give her my wife's wedding ring. Like, yep, here you go. Don't look too much into this, though. Alright, let's just... That's fine. I like how you can trade without actually asking them to follow, like you had to do in Skyrim. Transfer. Workshop. Oh, whoops, wrong thing. Workshop. Just put all this in there. I'll probably break these down later. Compensated armor-piercing 10mm auto pistol. I did not realize she had that. Maybe I gave that to her, I don't know. Fat man. I put this in my inventory off camera. I'm going to hold on to it just in case I encounter any super bosses that need to be nuked in a mini fashion. I don't have full-sized ICBMs just ready to throw down on any boss I encounter. That'd be a bit much. I also put the laser musket away. Oh crap, I meant to give her that submachine gun. Because I just don't want too many things in my inventory, and I felt like having this sniper rifle that I specifically crafted for myself, having the laser musket would be a little redundant, because why would I use that when I have this thing I built just for me? So that's my thinking behind that. A flare gun might be useful to summon allies. I put the machete away, right? Because I want to use a security baton. I like that. Okay. Oh, that's right. I had a bunch of apparel that I took from her, too. That away. Like I said, I'll probably break these down at a later time off camera. Oh, store all junk. Oh, great. Didn't realize I had a bunch of junk on me. The difficulty is still on survival, by the way. What's the angle of having all these mattresses in the middle of the street? I must understand. You'll never understand.
It stays hidden forever. At least, not if I have my say.
Yeah, can I talk to you, please?
Piper.
Head my way?
Trade.
Let's trade.
This is what I've got.
And weapon, submachine gun. There you go. Now she'll be even more useful in combat, I'd say. All she had last time was a 10mm pistol. Okay, let's move the beds back in. I'm also going to delete this stupid stank mattress. Build shelter. Oh, really? Your progress on a quest you already completed can, like, gradually deplete? I didn't know that. Alright. This will be Preston's room. Because he gets the painting. And he will get a nice bed. I gotta just place it with this stupid post in my way. No. There. Great. And hopefully I can assign him to that bed specifically. What the hell is this? Where did this come from? Oh, in the menu. I meant to select the bed. There we go. I thought I just joinked that off a random house. Now see, my friend Maverick is not quite as nice to his settlers as I am. See, I'm giving them individual rooms. Last I saw from a screenshot he posted, oh, come on with this. He just built one giant open room and just plopped sleeping bags everywhere and said, there, everyone just sleep. No privacy, no nothing. I hope he comments on this video now about that. It wasn't even beds, it was just sleeping bags on the floor. That's all you get. Still like that. Gotta have them centered. And I have to make one more bed because I took out the jank mattress, furniture, beds. Okay. Right there. Cha-ching. Yeah, I completed the quest for a second time. Preston. I want to remind you that this is your bed. Cool. I hope that works. I hope that's an actual thing. Alright. Where's Piper get to sleep? I don't know. She's a cool follower. I like her character. So, maybe I'll give her a better area. Like one of these already made houses. She could be my neighbor.
Maybe constantly trying to kill us, but
Commonwealth never... See? I took everything out. Even stuff that like sort of served a purpose, like furniture and things. You know, with the blue outline, I still took those out. I want to build everything myself. So I guess this would be the bedroom, right? Oh, I guess I missed that lampstand, though.
You didn't see that.
Okay, beds. Why can he not build, like, a freaking king-size bed? That's what I want. Are these the sleeping beds? Yeah. See, he just plopped it. Built a giant room, just put all these down. Okay. Let's give her this bed. Whoa, not in the air, though. Hold up. Hold up. There we go. Although, there's kind of a wall missing there. Can I just put up a wall there? On the side of it? Structures, metal, walls. I just want a flat wall. Flat wall! Here we go. Right? Yeah. Oh. Can you not attach anything to these houses? Oh, that sucks. Ooh! This is a good looking wall though for future reference. Barely any holes in it. Kind of funny that that's something you have to be happy about in this game. Barely any holes in this wall. That's usually something you'd expect from your walls, but in this universe, you just gotta take what you can get. Well, alright. We'll have her be our next door neighbor though. If I can find her. There she is. Go! Hey!
Most folks are just looking for a hand.
Oh, come on. Why do I have to sit through her saying her hello message first? Why can't I just straight up talk to her? Oh, I'm in the wrong thing. Never mind. Command. Oh, you can't sprint in building mode? Good news is the happiness is up to 18, which was up from, what, 6? Before I started all this, so that's an improvement. Okay, oh my god, are we almost at an hour already? Time flies when you're doing this stuff. Okay, I said I was going to give power to the building, so we're going to do that, and then we're going to do a Minuteman mission, and then I'm going to end it. Yeah, also I did level up, didn't I? Indeed I did. What sucks is I don't know what perk I want.
There's so many good ones.
I know I said I wanted this. This is also good. I also want the lockpicking one. I also want more agility, more luck, more perception. I want the armor and the blacksmith. I want so much! Look at this radiation resistance. Reducing limb damage. I mean, you get more health. There's a higher carry weight one here somewhere. There it is, just straight up insta carry weight gain. There's so many good perks. I love the skill tree. Well, here's a question for anyone who's played the game. What are some of your favorite perks in the game so far? I'm kind of curious because, like I just said, there's so many good ones in my opinion. So what are some of your favorites if you have any? I am curious to find out. I do want more AP. But I also want the locksmith. I also want science. What kind of stuff does the high-tech mods give me? Are there any things in here? Oh. Well, let's look at this. Upgrade. Electrified? Whoa, that's gonna be cool. And that's even cooler. Electrical damage and chance to stun. Okay, well, there's something that science will get me, although blacksmith, I need rank 2 in that. So that might be a while. Muzzle, is there anything here? Gun nut?
Please, just... I need to be alone right now.
Okay, you need to be alone. So why are you hanging around the one spot where everyone stays? This guy! Can you... Merv launcher? What's that do? An experimental modification. I don't know what that does. Does it tell me? That damage decrease! 468 to 18? But increases the value, so it's gotta do something good. Rank 4 science, rank 4 gun, it's gotta be good! There's something about that that... It just has to kick some serious ass, it just doesn't tell you until you get it. I really need to modify old trusty here. Reduce damage. By how much? Oh, 1 point, really? That's not too bad. Screw. Screw you! Any of you know that movie reference? That one's probably a hard one to get. Hint, Arnold Schwarzenegger movie. You know what? Let's just do it. Lighter weight. I like lightweight. Just a quick pistol. Yeah. Preston, like that. He's over there creeping behind me watching me make weapons. Short barrel, long barrel, long light barrel. Long barrel is standard? I didn't know that. Huh, okay. Standard grip.
Hello, sir.
Hello. Standard sights, close sights, improved focus, and better sighted accuracy.
I'll try to make my
nuclear material? That stuff sounds super rare. I ain't using that on a stupid pistol sight. Get away from me, man! Everyone's getting right up in my booty like they got nowhere else to be. So I need science and... Okay, well... Ooh, shotgun. Yeah, cancel. Let's look at the shotgun. I haven't looked at this yet, I don't think. Heavier weight, improved damage, better critical shot, just better damage. Better rate of fire, superior damage. Who the hell was that? Oh, is that to do with the pompadour? Yeah, it is. Powerful receiver. Screws, steel, oil, gear, adhesive. That seems fine. Although, I wish there was like a pump shotgun. I don't like this double barrel. So I'm going to leave it alone. I'm going to hold out and see if there's a different shotgun. I don't want to invest materials into something I don't really like. Okay, do you have something for me?
I just want to trade a few things.
I guess not. Unless he already gave me a quest. Sanctuary, provide clean water for sanctuary settlers. Hey, I've given you 60% water. What more do you want? Okay, so I guess this isn't enough. Yeah, we still need to do the power thing. I still need to pick a perk, which I might do off camera because there's just so much I want. I'm going to have to sit here and just decide. I need to plant some crops. What do you have back here? What's it? Oh, those are just weeds. Okay, don't eat those. What's this? We should keep moving. Don't want to be pinned down when the raiders come. I'm gonna be building this place up, lady! And you're gonna be the first one scheduled for guard duty. See, that's how you do it. What's your name again? Marcy. Piper offers to help. You're just like, let's just go wander out there in the wasteland for no reason. Okay, so I think wrong menu. I think to provide clean water, I need power, which is something I was going to do anyway. Resources. Water. Requires 2 power juice. Water purifier. Now, do I have to have a generator down first before it even lets me pick where I want to do this? Oh, I left this furniture up too because I need somewhere to sit. So maybe I should put it down here by the river, in a van down by the river. Which, by the way, in case you guys didn't know, there's actually a ruined house down here. Someone's house got blown to hell and it landed in the river. Oh, here's some stuff I didn't do. See, there's more bits of the house I found. Oh no, I got rads! Maple branches, get rid of this. Refrigerator door. I'm guessing that's the door to the refrigerator Indiana Jones used to escape his nuclear annihilation. From what I heard, everybody thought that was a plausible event and they loved it. That movie scored raving reviews. I bet I could scrap that tire. Now, I wish you could build stone walls like this. These are cool looking. They're like Whiterun walls. Okay, so I was thinking maybe put like the water purifier down here, because it kind of makes sense to like buy the water source. Although I know there's like water tables and stuff, but this is a little cooler. So I guess we could put like a wind generator down here and then put it by the water. Yeah, that makes sense, right? Power! Generators. Where's the wind turbine? Here it is. Can I put it in the river? Yes, I can. Which way do I want it to face, though? What does it take? Copper or aluminum gear? Okay, that should be alright. Let's just face it this way, and then if it looks stupid, we'll turn it around. Alright. Right here. Connect objects that require power to it. Okay. Oh, that's right. I don't have to rebuild it. I can just rotate it if I want. It's not doing much. That's not a whole lot of power. Whoops, I didn't want to do that. Cancel. Thank you. All right, let's do the water. Water purifier. Oh, it has to be placed in the water anyway. Okay, so, right? Must be placed in the water. It's all in the water right there. Do you see how much in the water it is? Okay, so let's put it here. Right. Unless like it can also be up by the water pump. Like maybe that'll count. I highly doubt it. What the fuck are you doing? He's so depressed he doesn't even want to deal with gravity. Like, that's how depressed he is. It's pretty damn impressive, honestly. What is that? What is that? Oh, it's a bug. Dead bug. Alright, let's put this over here. I'm trying to make it in a place people can easily access it. This looks okay. Built. Cool. See, I don't know if I want... You powered up your first object. Congratulations! I don't know if I want the blade to be facing towards town or away from it. This seems okay. That's fine. No! Cool. What exactly does that provide again? I forget. Produces 10 water. Requires 2 power. Damn, that's cool. You know what else we might do? Maybe like have a light down here. Just because people might need water at nighttime. There. Hopefully that helps. I hope so. Can't really tell when it's like midday, but it's something. Now, can I do anything here?
Looks like it's in working order.
Cool.
Looks like it's in working order.
Oh, now it's in working order. Okay, so you can shut it off if you want to. Is this even on? Activate! Okay, activating this does absolutely nothing. Note to self. Okay, so we got the water purifier. I guess if anyone knows, can you do anything with the water purifier, or is that purely for your settlers? Like, I thought you could collect purified water. That'd be cool. That stuff's useful for cooking and healing yourself. Blowfly. I guess I'll take that. I mean, if it's just gonna sit there being dead. Right, does this dude have any more quests for me while I'm here? Your energy! Move!
Hey, Sturgis.
I feel better already, knowing we have a reliable supply of clean water. I hope you don't mind me asking for some more help, but our food supplies are running low.
Yeah.
We're gonna settle here. We'll need to get some crops established.
Okay, so this dude is the tutorial for settlements. Provide food for sanctuary settlers, 30%.
What kind of crops are you looking for?
It doesn't much matter. Potatoes, mute fruit, corn.
Oh, it's mute fruit? Get out of here! Depressing Dave! I hate this guy!
Just looking to trade a little.
Oh, I can't have that conversation anymore.
Anything fresh will be a great change for us.
Great. Depressed Dave just soiled it for me. Cord. Melon. Oh, those weren't weeds. Those are just melons that weren't in harvest yet. And yet somehow grew to full size within 5 minutes. Okay, so how exactly do I plant? I've got carrots. I've got them. Oh. There we go. Like, I don't know why I forgot about that. Resources, food, carrots. Now, if I recall, some vegetables can be used to make adhesive, which is very useful for weapons. Weapon crafting. Okay. Now, I think... Where did I want the farmland to be? If you guys remember in the first episode, I said I want to, like, plan where I want everything. And I kind of like this area for farmland. I wish I could get rid of these stupid things. There was a swing set I got rid of, but you can't get rid of these. I mean, I guess this back here is okay. And I don't really see any better areas. Oh, missed a few things. By the way, just a little helpful thing that I learned is when you're going around scrapping things, you know how to press R to scrap, and it says press Enter to scrap. You can also press E in place of Enter. So it's way faster than pressing R and then using your other hand to press Enter over and over. You can just press RE, 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 and go super fast, quick-like. Okay, so we're good on power, we're good on water. Defense sucks. And we need food. Alright, I guess we'll just go with this for now. I can always change this up. So we'll do carrot. Carrot. You must assign a worker to this object before it can begin producing resources. Can she only work? How many can she work? Huh, command. For most powered objects, a worker that is already assigned to produce food can work on multiple food producing objects up to a maximum of 6 food total. Okay, so that's 1, 2, 3. Does that even count as food? It only counts my 2 food. Oh, carrots produce half food each. Okay, so we got 1, 2. Existing farmers will automatically. God, it's going through the tooltips too fast! It's blazing through! It's a maximum 6 defense total. So does it mean 6 food objects or 6 things worth of food? Because either this can be two objects or 1 thing worth of food. I didn't get time to read that. God damn it. Assign. Okay, are you good? You're just digging, you're just playing in the dirt. You're not even like focusing on the crops. Food. Corn. What fruit plant? Well, I got 6 of those. Produces a whole food? Oh god, we got a whole foods here. Juniper berries. Juniper berries. Okay, can I assign you to more food? Fuck. Assign. Okay, so if it's 6 total food per settler, it's 1, 2, 3 food, 3.5 food, 4.5 food. She should be able to operate all this. And if it's only 6 objects, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 objects. Well, let's see. Let's plant another mud fruit plant. And see if I command her to do it. Will food up top increase to 5? Oh god. Oh god. 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 food. Okay. So it must be 6 food total per settler. Great. Let's do corn. 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 Command. Oh, nope. Do I not have to do it? So she does automatically get the food. Wait a fuck. Oh, I didn't have to put a second one down, did I? Shit. Cancel. I'll just leave it there. Whatever. Because I forgot. We got 1, 2, 3 food. 4 food. 5 food. 6 food. So it's 6.5. Whoops. Whoa, I had to pause the recording. I had a mega sneeze coming on. Didn't want to just blow that right into the microphone. Okay. Oh! God. We're already over an hour! This is a lot of fun. I hope you guys are enjoying watching this. But time goes so fast when I'm doing this. Because I still have a quest I want to do for the Minutemen. My god. Oh, there's 2 quests because I have to set up a settler beacon thingy. Down at the thing. The drive-in. Okay, how did I want to do this? Put his doghouse here. It seems like he's crammed in, so that's just going to be like a back porch. We'll just have him out back. Because look, if I put it here, he doesn't get much space, and the door's right there. Just make him walk through the bushes to get inside. Now we'll put him out back here. That's fine. Oh, he's got bushes in there, though. That sucks. No, we'll have him out front. We don't want to stuff him in the back. We'll have him out front. Yeah, see, don't pay no attention to those floating bits in the front. We'll put him right there. Oh, he's got grass in there, too. That bothers me. Here we go. This looks good. See, there's a little bit of grass, but not a lot. That should be good. Okay, now we have to supply power to the buildings. Although, you know what? I might save the power supply until part 3. Because we are really deep into the episode already, and I don't want this to be another 2-hour one. Oh, shit. We need to move his dog bowl over there, though. That's important. We got the rug there, too. Although nobody seemed to appreciate the rug. My guess is the next quest the dude is going to make us do is to increase defense. So I'll deal with that later. Let's put his doggy bowl right here. Huh. Perfect. Okay. So just like in the main Let's Play, part 1 was a disaster. So was part 2. But as the series went on, I started to learn more and things got better. Part 1 of the Settlement series included nothing about the settlements. But part 2, stuff is actually done. So I guess as both series proceed, things get better. So, I'm happy about that. Is anyone in here sleeping? Hopefully I can... Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, that's right. Piper is in that house over there. Speaking of the dog, which, by the way, for part 7 of the Fallout 4 main Let's Play, I will have the official new dog name selected. A name that was suggested by one of the viewers. I will do that. But for now, he is still named Dog, and I might take him along with me for this next quest. Or I might take Piper, I'm not sure yet. coming down here to make sure the light actually works. Does it illuminate anything? It does. Cool. Well, that's what I wanted. That still doesn't do anything. What stinks is this thing is like right out in the open. Like bandits could go on the other side and just start shooting at it just to make us mad. Hopefully they won't do that. Okay, so for at least one more night, everyone's gonna have to sleep in the dark. Pitch black, no power, no nothing. But power, it will soon arrive to the rest of the town. So let's go ahead and take a look-see at the quests. I got the ghoul one first. Taking point Sunshine Tidings Co-op. What the fuck is that? I don't remember getting that. I don't remember getting that. Clear Sunshine Tidings Co-op. Is that the one I got in the last episode? Oh, man. Show on map. Holy jeebus! It's way out in the west. That's super far. I thought I was supposed to set up something here. In Starlight Drive. Well, let me go try that anyway and see what happens. And I guess we'll go to the other settlement. And just like that, I already forgot to take Piper or the dog. Like, I forget shit so fast. Also, what the hell is going on in this neck of the woods? Whatever it is, what's that, 4 bandits versus 2 dudes? And they got their asses whooped? Also, I thought I saw somebody run over here. I guess I only see 2 people. Oh! No, it's another cow. Let's go talk to these guys. Wait, come back! Please don't kill me, though! What are you? Settler.
Excuse me.
Ain't looking for trouble, I hope.
Hi. Hope you ain't one of them synths here to spy on me.
Where's your nose? Michael Jackson, is that you? Oh, there's the person. Why didn't they show up on my vats? You're another settler, I bet.
Hey.
Huh?
Huh?
I can't remember the last time I had clean fingernails.
Ugh! I'm just gonna moonwalk this way. Now where is... Here it is. Starlight Drive. Starlight Drive Inn. Excuse me. Oh, Catmine? Oh shit. Oh god. Oh man, oh god, oh man. Oh, I've also forgot to favorite the nightstick. Five. Let's take a look at that. Ooh, that's cool. I like that. Alright. Oh, that's even more badass! Ah, that's so cool! I love it. Put it away. Shit. Don't blow up on me. Quick save for the love of God! Alright, I disarmed it. Take. Aluminum can. Oh, God! Come on, man! How the hell was I supposed to know that was there? It did quick beep 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 boom! Like, come on! Jesus! See, the first one was out in the open to get you feeling good. Like, yeah, I disarmed it. Big whoop. Want to fight about it? And then it's like, yeah, I do want to fight about it by taking your arms off. Ugh. Well, I'm not in combat. Although now this is on survival. I don't know how long it'll take for these things to regenerate it. Or regenerate it. Regenerate. But until I'm in combat, I'm just going to leave them alone. They're fine already? They're not fine? What part of that looks fine to you? Shut up. I took 3 things in an effort to just shut that radio off. Wrench, I saw a light bulb. There it is. Broom. I don't know if the cigarettes are useful for anything. I haven't checked to see if... any building things require those. Potato crisps? Why are they called crisps here? This is America. We don't call them crisps. I don't have any problem with calling them crisps, I'm just saying. Since nobody calls them crisps here, why is it called that in the game? Oh my god. He's like, bruh. I will take your pillow. He's like, oh, that was my knife on the mattress. Oh. Dirty water. You can purify that though, right? I'll take it. You shank a hat. Lantern, take. Oh, coffee cup. So I'm supposed to set up a beacon. To be like, hey, survivors, we got a kick-ass place if you want to join. Although I feel like that might also invite raiders, too. Flask. You know, I'm also surprised that mine that blew up on me just didn't kill me outright. Anything down here? I know I've been here already, but I didn't really loot the place. Okay, oh, I just realized this is another settlement, right? Indeed it is. I can scrap all these cars and stuff. Well, what's cool is I have rank 1 in the community leader thing. And I could set up a supply line. So scrapping all the stuff, and then I could have it link back to Sanctuary.
Yes.
Yes! Duct tape, pipe wrench, chalk. Chalk zone! Bag of cement. I don't really see anything else besides the workbench, obviously. Or workshop. Dead guy. Alright, let's set up the beacon. Where would that even be? Here? Recruitment radio beacon. Alright. Oh god, I gotta do the power first. Let's just set up a... Oh, I ain't got none of the stuff, none of the goods! I gotta start breaking stuff down. What do I need? Rubber and copper. I've got one copper. I'm sure there's tires around here. Does this give me tires? No. Clearly there's tires on this van, but it won't give me the rubber for it. Oh! Wait, I have to be able to clean this junk up. What am I gonna do? Build a settlement around a radiation pool? Are you serious? Oh my god, the radius. Look at that. I can't even clean that up. I can't get close enough to just like scrap it. Well, ain't that a bunch of junk? Ugh. Alright, let's look for tires. Can I scrap that? Oh, is that a tire? Oh, no, it's not a tire. Copper? Oh, whoa! Okay, so the street lamp has rubber in it? I think I need one more copper. Wait a minute, I need way more than that. I thought I had circuitry. It showed. Oh, no, I had it for the generator. The hell was that? Oh, sorry, Mr. Skeleton. Okay, so I got the generator. Give the radiation pool a wide berth. Super wide. Huh. Coffee cup removed. And now I need the recruitment beacon. Although, why do I want to put this here? I want to put it at Sanctuary. I don't want people here. I ain't going to use this. It's got a radiation pool in the middle. So I need circuitry, crystal, copper, crystal. Oh, that's a bunch of shit, man. This sucks. I have to come back here later. Although, there might be something in here. Rubber, fuse, broken light bulb, great. Yeah, I still need that fancy stuff. And I'm gonna have to waste the resources to put it here. I guess I'll ask you guys, is there a benefit to putting it in Sanctuary instead of here? Because I want more settlers at Sanctuary. That's going to be like my main base. Unless I find a place I think is cooler. Then I'll just try and transfer stuff. But until then, I don't want none of this. Alright. I also want to visit one of the other settlements I have that has settlers, which I think is Ten Pines and... there's another one. This? Oberlin Station. See if I can set up a supply line. And see if I can move the settlers? Like, I don't know if I can move them to other places or what. So let's try this. Let's go to Ten Pines. See if we can move one of the settlers. Then we're going to pick up either the dog or Piper and go do a mission and then end the episode. This is going to be a mega long video. Okay, we are here. Wow, look at all that radiation damage I have. Also, how are my limbs? Absolutely fine. Although my legs are still damaged, I don't understand why that is. Hi.
Hey, Sheffield. What do you think about coming to work for me?
Thank you. It's like I can finally think straight.
Yeah, somehow he's wearing more raggedy clothes than he was before.
Just wanted to trade a few things.
Ah, shit, that's right. I gotta be in the other menu.
I gave up alcohol after settling down here. Doctor said I shot my liver.
Whoops. Where are the other people? Aha. Uh-huh. Settler. Go. Store? What the fuck? How do I make them go somewhere else? Move? This person cannot be moved from this settlement. Well, shit. I do supply line? Send settler to Sanctuary Hills. Or should I send the... alcohol... or alcoholic guy? Come back! Nice house you got here, though. Oh, I can move this guy. So what? I guess you can't move settlers that are originally at a settlement. Since these two were here when I first got here, they can't be moved. But I can move the alcoholic guy. I don't know. I want a supply line here, but I don't know who I want to send. I think I'll send the alcohol guy. These two were here together before, and I don't want to split them up. So let's send this guy. Hey! Hey, you guys! Supply line. Sanctuary Hills. There he goes! Whee! And from what my friend Maverick told me, is when you set up a supply line, they're supposed to walk back and forth. Is that how it goes? So let me see if I have all my materials now. Just open this up. Yeah, I do. Hell yeah. Excellent. Workshop? That's not what I wanted. I didn't mean to do that. Transfer. Junk. Wait a minute. Now I'm not sure. Well, it says I only have 10 steel here, and yet I'm able to build a structure with over 1,000 steel. Supposedly in my inventory. See? So I'm guessing I can put my junk here and I can use it at Sanctuary too because I have a supply line? Or is it only one way? Can I only put my junk in Sanctuary and be able to use it here, but I can't use the junk here in Sanctuary? I don't know. So until then, I'm just going to store everything at Sanctuary. Including the junk I picked up at the stupid drive-in. Alright, so let's go get a follower. Although, now that I'm thinking about it, and I hate to say this after I've kind of been, I don't know, hyping it up throughout the episode, I think it might be best to wait until part 3 to go do a mission, because we're already at an hour and a half long, roughly, estimated. And if I do a mission, it'll easily hit 2 hours, if not more, and I think that's just too long for people to sit through. Hour and a half is long enough as it is, but 2 hours plus, that's just way too long. I don't think anyone will sit through the whole thing, so... I think the best move is to just end it here, and in the next episode we'll start off with a mission and then come back and supply power to the two buildings I built. And that should be a good part three. That'll probably take up an hour on its own as well. So sorry about that, but I just think it's the best plan. So thank you guys very much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed it. And I will see you all in the next one for some more Fallout 4 Settlement series action. Take care, everybody. Bye.